Mark 3. Mark 4. Big 4. Ocean D.
We're embarking on a steam-powered journey along the rivers of America. On our trip, we'll visit the magnificent Columbia, Great Northwest, the powerful Potomac, Mid-Atlantic, and the rugged Rio Grande along the border of Texas and Mexico. We'll hear the voices of the pioneers, the native people, and the mysterious character of the two, telling the unique stories and legends of life along America's great river. We begin our trip on the mighty Mississippi, heading south, and ending up down in New Orleans.
Red flag and the chain.
If you're new to the river, you're probably wondering about those calls. That's the legend, calling out the depth markings so we can avoid running aground.
Mark Twain.
Those are the two sweetest words a riverman can hear. It means the water is 2 fathoms deep, safe enough for river boats like ours to travel through. But Mark Twain means something else these days. It's also the name of an author, a witty fellow who used to pilot a stern wheeler himself in his day.
When I was a boy, there was but one ambition among my comrades in our village. That was to be a steamboat. We had ambitions of other sorts, to become clowns, to be pirates. These ambitions faded out. The ambition to be a steamboatman always remained. Of course, when I was younger, I could remember anything, whether it happened or not.
Up on the ridge is an Indian chief, giving us a sign of peace. Seems appropriate, given how peaceful the waters are here in the backwoods.
Indian village ahead, Captain!
Ahead is a tribe of Plains Indians that has set up camp along the river. And there's the wise old shaman, sharing his knowledge with the young braves. If I'm translating properly, he's telling the story of how a woodpecker taught a young tribesman to carve holes in a hollowed-out branch, blowing air through the branch, then created a strange yet beautiful sound. That's how the Lakota discovered the flute. Continue on. Keep a close eye on the riverbanks. There's a good chance we might catch a glimpse of moose, eagles, mountain lions, and other wildlife.
Mm-hmm.
Pirate's Lair, Tom Sawyer Island, off the starboard side. I tell you, if there was one thing young Tom always said he wanted to be, it was a pirate.
It's just a lot for me. You don't have to get up mornings, and you don't have to go to school and wash, and all that blade foolishness. You see, pirates don't have to do anything.
To go ashore.